Now we're going to see the spinal cord. Let's do a cross section of spinal cord. So, oops, it looks awful. More or less, something like this. So there would be posterior horns. These are the posterior horns and anterior horns. More or less like this. So this is a cross section. Let's put first all the tracts. We have ascending and descending tracts. The descending tract include mostly the motor pathway, and ascending tract include the sensory and some proprioception, a little bit of arrangement of the motion, etc. So first see the corticospinal tract. Corticospinal tract. Remember that we have a anterior and lateral corticospinal tract. The anterior corticospinal tract will be here. Anterior corticospinal tract. And the lateral corticospinal tract would be here. Lateral corticospinal tract. Then we have the vestibulospinal tract here, like here. We have hypothalamus spinal tract, that is descending tract, and is mostly here together with the lateral corticospinal tract. Now, ascending, we have spinocerebellar tract. Spinocerebellar tract, that is lateral. So here is spinocerebellar tract. Lateral spinothalamic tract for pain and temperature. And here we have anterior spinothalamic tract. Anterior is for crude touch and pressure, and lateral spinothalamic tract is for pain and temperature sensation. And we also have here spinocerebellar, dorsal spinocerebellar tract, and here ventral spinocerebellar tract that are damaged on Friedreich's ataxia and vitamin B12 deficiency. Alright, so this is a cross section. Here are the anterior horns, in which lower motor neurons are, posterior horns, and sometimes there is these lateral horns. Lateral horns. Now, how would we distinguish if we have a cervical, thoracic, or lumbar section, and at which level? Look, we have three things that we can use to distinguish. First will be here. This is the dorsal, or this is the dorsal funiculus. In the dorsal funiculus, we have gracilis funiculus and cuneatus funiculus. And remember that these are involved in proprioception. Gracilis would be for lower limbs, and cuneatus for upper extremities and trunk. Before arriving to the distinction, we have here, we have sacral, lumbar, trunk, and upper limb. Here I forgot to say about the lateral corticospinal tract and lateral spinothalamic tract, anterior spinothalamic tract, and anterior corticospinal tract. We have First, the cervical region, then the thoracic, lumbar, and sacral. Cervical is more at the center. Again, cervical, thoracic, lumbar, sacral. And now this, that is the home of the lower motor neurons. Here we have lower motor neurons that go to flexor muscles and to extensor muscles. And we have first the head, forearm, arm, and neck. Alright, now the distinguish is in the cuneatus fasciculus is not always present. It's not present at all the levels of the spinal cord. It is present only above T5. Above T5 is when the proprioception begins for the upper motor nerve, upper limbs. So we will ask, is there both dorsal columns? If yes, then we are talking about a spinal section that is above T5. And if we only see the gracilis fasciculus, then we are below T5. Next question. Is there a lateral horn? Lateral horn would be here, the sympathetic neurons, preganglionic neurons, and the sympathetic, sympathetic location are on the thoracic spinal tract or thoracic sections. So this lateral horns will only be seen at the level of spinal cord sections from T1 to L2, around there. So is there a lateral horn? Yes. So we're talking about T1 to L2. No. Then we're talking either from C1 to C8 or from from L3 to S2, for example. And lastly, sometimes we have a anterior enlargement of the anterior horns, as in this one. And this anterior enlargement is when the cervical, it's called the cervical enlargement, because occurs from C5 to C8, C5 to T1, that is where the upper plexus or the brachial plexus is going to arrive. So we have a cervical enlargement. And there is also another enlargement that is going to go to the lumbosacral plexus. And this occurs at L1 to S2. So is any cervical enlargement? Yes. Then we are talking either from C5 to T1 or L1 to S2. There is no cervical enlargement. Then we're talking about C1 to C4 or T2 to T12 or L1 around there. So let's see. I have a cross section in which there is a cervical enlargement. We see both dorsal columns, and I see a lateral horn. So I see both dorsal columns, so I am above T5. I see lateral horn, yes, so I am between T1 and L2. So because it's above T5, I know that I'm between T1 and T5. And I see a cervical enlargement. Cervical enlargement is C5 to T1 or L1 to S2. Because I am between T1 and T5, then the only one would be at T1.